is in preparation of a kind used in animal feeding. Three items to provide animal with a rational or balanced diet. That is, it's a complete food. And to achieve suitable daily diet by supplementing, this is a supplemental food, then for use in making complete or supplemental feed. This is an input, this as such will be used along with the food. Even then it will be an animal feed, that's what it is. And small quantities normally it is used.
Supplement is the area where there is a control in case of import. So they are saying that no, this additive is not covered by that specific exemption notification under customs. So people tariff rate is 30%, exemption rate is 20%. People everything they are claiming under 20% and they have been importing that. And that's where the whole controversy is now.
These are judgments which we need not elaborate further. The classification of machinery for this thing is agriculture, horticulture machineries are falling under 8436 for poultry and other agriculture, horticulture sector. This may be relevant. Whereas the machinery not specifically included in that will be under 8438. And attract 18%. There is a rate difference in there. Therefore, it has to be established that they are only for this type of agriculture, horticulture, forestry. Specifically, it should be machinery for specific for this. If it is used for any other preparation for food and this thing, it may not be classified under that 8438 it will be. Then there is an implication of the input tax credit, as I earlier, for animal feed manufacturers, they face this problem of manufacturing both taxable and exempted products. Therefore, the exempted supplies and taxable supplies, the apportionment of credit attributable to exempted supply has to be reversed or given back. That is what
just to add here, I think this was a sector which was earlier not in the full stream of the credit regime in the earlier in the VAT side. And based on our interaction with the poultry clients, to understand how apportionment happening, what way you can take credit, people are either taking full credit or they are not taking credit. I think there is some bit of rationalization is definitely needed to understand when can you take credit and when cannot you take credit. And not that everything is creditable and not that everything you can't take credit. So based on our experience dealing with the leading groups in Pune so far as the poultry industry is concerned, we kind of got a sense that this is the area where people may have a question or people may have some bit of confusion.
Even those experienced people who are continuously manufacturing both dutiable and exempted, semi credit rule 6 was there, they all face problem. Each and every manufacturer at one point of time or other, they have got this notice under from Central Excise Department that your reversal is not correct and you should have taken into account this trading is done and this electricity is billed out, all those these things that for the first time maybe poultry and the animal feed sector may be facing that.
Just before you start, I think this is where industry has to do some bit of introspection that assuming my credit is higher side and my output tax I am not paying and because there is some exemption and because of that there are some difficulty we are facing. This is the right time to go to the government also to say that you please withdraw the exemption on this particular product. Or if you are giving exemption, then you give exemption throughout so that my inputs are also not taxable and my outputs are also not taxable. So yeah. Some bit of introspection, some bit of study and which will vary from organization to organization, sector to sector. That sort of thing also can be done.
This as a last this thing slide we have covered, what are the way forward we have covered this, what representations you can make for the purpose of the cost being increased for the animal feed because of it. This input tax credit, everyone must be knowing that. Goods and services used are intended to be used by a supplier in the course of furtherance of business. If it is for personal use, it will not be. it is in the course of furtherance of business. In furtherance of business, further it will be apportioned between the taxable supply and the exempted supply. Zero rated supply, which is for export and supply to SEZ, are all treated as on par with taxable supply. In capital goods, there is a slight difference between the earlier definition under central excise. Central excise, if it is used in the factory, that is sufficient. Whereas in GST, it is used for used in the business and if it is capitalized in the books of account. This we have explained, reversal of input tax credit, apportionment of credit.
And if you see this particular section, section 17, with respect to apportionment, that itself is a separate topic in itself. And that will vary from company to company, industry to industry, that how this particular section is going to impact.
As I said, there is a provision which says that for the goods, if the input tax credit is input tax is higher than the output tax, then the outflowing unutilized credit will be given as refund. But the provision also says that in certain cases the government can deny this also by way of specifying those goods. And also it says that it will not be applicable in a case where the output supply is chargeable to nil rate of duty or wholly exempt. So as an animal feed manufacturer, the final product is chargeable to nil. Therefore, even if 5% if input some input is there, some input services are this, then there is no question of getting the refund. Therefore, retracting will become cost. Therefore, we can what we can do for that, we will come to deal. See that in the end of the discussion. Then the poultry sector, basically they are they will be treated as producing agriculture produce. Whether the agriculture produce, therefore agriculture produce is the term which has to be understood. For those services which are in relation to agricultural operation, specified services are exempt. If they are in relation to agricultural operation, for the production of the product which are agriculture, which are covered by agricultural produce definition. Therefore, agricultural produce definition is very important to look into. It says that it means any product out of cultivation of plant and rearing of all life of all forms of animal except rearing of horse. And this rearing of animals should be for food, fiber, fuel, raw material or other similar product on which either no further processing is done or such processing is done as is usually done by a cultivator or producer. A cultivator or producer, whatever he does something for marketing the agricultural produce, that to that extent only that is. If it is further processed, that further processing will not be covered by the agricultural produce definition. That is, the processed item. After that, let us assume that poultry is producing chickens, and then this is life is sold, or it is sold after meat is taken and then meat and offals are sold in fresh and chilled form. That to that extent it will be the same. If that is further processed by way of heating, smoking or drying or whatever other process, whether still it will be called as a person who buys it and then does this activity for somebody else for as a service, whether that service will be covered by agriculture service. That's a question. The question, if the poultry person gives the chick of 1 year, 1 day old or whatever it is, that and then ask the farmer to rear it and then give that back to him for as a service. That will be a service, agricultural service covered by them. But if it is after it is the meat is taken and then the meat is given to somebody to process it and then put it in a pack and then give it, whether that process also done as a job or as a service by somebody, whether that will be covered by agricultural service. According to us,
this will mainly cover all your input services. So assuming you are a poultry farm or you are into this particular business, so whatever your input services, either you may be engaging the farmer for doing that particular growing the chick, that is one activity. You may be engaging a transporter. You may be engaging a various contractor who will be basically handling the eggs. Okay, so multiple activities will be involved. So what are the activities?
If you outsource that activity, that will be a service.
So what are the activity which will fit into the exemption? What are the activity which will not fit, will not be fitting into the exemption? I think this particular entry will take care of that. So if it is agriculture produce, as we were, you were mentioning, which honestly I was not aware that egg without shell is also a sellable commodity. But if somebody is doing only that activity, you give him the egg and he is removing the shell and packing it and giving it, he is not working on the agricultural thing. It is basically further processing of that. That particular activity will definitely be attracting a particular GST. But if somebody is only transporting the eggs or transporting the chicken or
that
transporting
will be
the one day old chick, then definitely those activities will be exempted.